Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about adding and subtracting unlike fractions. Unlike fractions are fractions that have different denominators. In order to add unlike fractions, we have to first rewrite them to have the same denominator. That's called finding the least common denominator, or LCD. Finding the LCD is the same as finding the LCM. Add the following unlike fractions and reduce if possible. The first two, I'm going to use pictures to show you what's happening. I have 1/4, and so here's something with four parts, and I have 1/4 shaded. And the other one is 1/3, and so I have 1/3 shaded. My shading's not very good here, but you get the point. So I have 1/3 and I have 1/4, but what do I have all together? Well, they're two different parts. They have two different amounts in there. So what I want to do is find some way that I can add those together. And the least common denominator here is 12, because 3 goes into 12 and 4 goes into 12. These two don't have any factors in common, so to find the LCD, you would just multiply them and get 12. So if I took this and I cut this up into four parts, and I cut this up into four parts, and I cut this up into four parts. Now I have 12 parts, and I have four parts shaded out of that 12. Up here, let's say that I just divided this down into thirds like this. Now I have 3, 6, 9, 12 parts. So even though my 12s look a little different, I have 12 even parts here and I have 12 even parts there. So now I can add those together because I have 3 out of 12. So 1/4 is the same as 3/12. And then I have 4, so 1/3 is the same as 4/12. And now that I have those written as 12s, I can add those together and we can see that we're going to get 3/12 plus 4/12, which is 7/12. Once I write them as like fractions, I keep the denominator the same and add the numerators. So this is what's happening. We're rewriting those so that we can add those together. Now this picture over here would be a little more obvious because fifths and tenths work nicely together because 5 actually goes into 10. So the LCD here would be 10. And so if I had 3/5, that is 3 of these parts shaded, and then I had 3/10, that is 3 of these parts shaded. Well, in order to add those together, I would just take my fifths and make that into tenths. And then I could see that I have 6, 7, 8, 9 tenths altogether because 3/5, we can see from the picture, is the same as 6/10. And you remember, if we build that 5 times 2 is 10, 3 times 2 is 6, so that makes sense. So what I have is 6/10 plus 3/10. Notice I didn't change the tenths because it already had the right number in the denominator. And if I add those together, I get 9/10, which you can see from my picture is true. So that's what's happening. We're not going to use pictures for the rest of these, but I wanted you to get a sense of what's happening when we're changing those denominators. Sometimes the denominator, the LCD, is not obvious like it was in the first two problems. So we have to maybe use our method from before. The method from before was to take our two numbers and divide by what they have in common. This was the LCM method, but LCD is just the same, only we're talking about fractions and denominators. So what number goes into both of these? Well, 6 goes in. 6 goes into 18 3 times. 6 goes into 24 4 times, and there's nothing that goes into 3 and 4 aside from 1, which doesn't help. So our LCD here is 6 times 3 times 4. Now 6 times 3 times 4 is 72. So our LCD is 72. Now I don't want to draw a picture with 72 parts in it, partly why I didn't try to do that. But I'm going to take my two fractions, and what you'll find is when you've done fractions in the past, you may have done them vertically like this. This is horizontal, which it's fine to work things horizontally, but you can also rewrite them vertically. What I want to do is rewrite my fractions to have 72s in the denominator because that's the common denominator that I found. So if I take 72 and divide by 18, I get 4. So that means I'm going to multiply 18 times 4 to get 72, and then I have to multiply 5 times 4 and get 20. Remember that 72 is our common denominator. That's why we're heading for that. Now if I'd say, well, what do I have to multiply 24 by to get 72? That's 3. So then I say, well, I have to multiply 24 times 3, so I have to multiply 1 times 3. And that gives me now, like fractions, keep the denominator the same and add the numerators. That gives me 23. If I could reduce, I would. So far, I haven't had to reduce any of these fractions. But my answer here is 23/72. Okay, the next one has three different denominators, so I have to find a number that all three of those go into. And so I'm going to use my method, 5, 3, and 12. Is there anything that goes into all three of these numbers? No. Anything that goes into 2? Yes. 3 goes. So I'm going to take that 3 out. 5 comes down unchanged. 3 goes into 3 one time, and 3 goes into 12 four times. Nothing goes into these numbers aside from 1, so I'm finished. I'm going to multiply my LCD here. Is going to be 3 times 5 times 1 times 4. And that's 15 times 4, or 60. You can always multiply that out if you like. 3 times 5 times 1 times 4 is 60. So our LCD is 60. I'm going to write these vertically again, but I can also do it horizontally. I have no problem with how you decide to do it. This is how most people learn to do it, and so I find that they're comfortable with this. I'm going to rewrite this as 60. I'm going to rewrite this with a 60, and I'm going to rewrite that. The fractions that I'm writing are equivalent fractions. 5 times 12 is 60, so 12 times 1. 3 times 20 is 60. 2 times 20 is 40. And 5 times 12 is 60, 7 times 5 is 35. So you can divide those to find out what you have to multiply by. But now I have a common denominator of 60, and I'm going to add my numerators. I have 12 plus 40 plus 35, and that gives me 87. And so I know that I can rewrite this as a mixed number if I'm asked to. 60 goes into 87 one time, with 27 left over. Now, you might ask yourself, can I reduce 27 over 60? You can put that into your calculator. Every calculator has a function of reducing. It's just about everyone, if you've gotten a scientific calculator for sure. You can hit that and put your fraction and hit enter. If you don't know how to do that on your calculator, ask your instructor if it's okay to use a calculator. And if so, ask them how to do that. That's 1 and 9 over 20. All right. We're going to finish this adding unlike fractions in the next video. Have a great day.